to introduce a gentleman who has been a guitar player. He's also Jessica Barron's good friend and the founding artist of guitars in the classroom. Ah. And also, right after the 60s ended and after a few years, Mr. Paul McCartney asked this gentleman, along with some other friends, to be in a group called Wings. And so we have the guitar player from some a piece of history that I know, based on your emails, touches a lot of you deeply. And that is probably the most wonderful thing I've experienced this year, is to hear your reactions, and I mean that truly. So without further ado, may I please introduce Mr. Lawrence Juber.
Tune D, G, D, G, B, D. And what's interesting about this tuning is the impact that it can have compositionally. Because Keith Richards tunes his guitar in open G tuning. Spanish Fandango. It comes from the same guitaristic source. And it's fascinating to follow that. Much in the same way as in flamenco music, you'll find that there are certain chord formations that are just fundamental to the style and chords that will just move up and down the neck. But so when you're working in open G tuning, just remember, it has a long and illustrious history. But I'm going to get to standard tuning right now. But for me, changing from one tuning to another, the meta information, the musical information, never changes. I mean, you know, a D is always a D, an E is always an E, just the position on the fingerboard may change. So when I'm approaching it, I'm still thinking in terms of the musical information. It's not just muscle.
A combination of lecture and demo from Brent about the process of recording Happy, and you're going to be hearing and seeing and looking at this cool thing that he created.
Producer might come in with an idea, a song idea, and start by just programming the kick drum. At this point, you would have a little MIDI keyboard connected to your software, okay? This software happens to be Logic. GarageBand is the smaller brother of it. And you'd have a little, you'd press record, and you'd start recording the kick drum. That's where typically a producer would start. After recording the kick drum, you'd probably put record on the snare drum and add a snare drum. After recording the snare drum, the producer would take record off, put record on the hi-hat, and start recording the hi-hat. fairly simple, right, you guys? Like, so we have three tracks there. After we're done with them, probably put the congas on. So now, we have the beat made. So there's just four tracks, you guys. This is one of the world's biggest songs in, you know, ever, right? If we can start to use these things that are very accessible to the kids and that the kids are using, if we can start to use these to entice them to start learning music, come on, right? That's what I'm saying. That's why I wanted to open this up for you guys to go, this is this massively successful song that's very simple at the core. Let's use songs like this to keep kids in school and keep art going. That's my soapbox.
Because they're going.